Hello friends, today's topic is definition of perquisite. Perquisite is defined under subsection 2 of section 17 of the Income Tax Act. Perquisite is a non-monetary benefit provided by the employer to the employee. Non-monetary benefit could be the value of the accommodation, value of the housing accommodation provided by the employer. It could be hotel accommodation, it could be car benefit provided by the employer to the employee, it could be the club facility, it could be the lunch coupons, it could be the dinner coupons provided by the employer to the employee. Everything which is in non-monetary terms and it is termed as benefit, and it arises out of the employer and employee relationship, it will be termed as benefit or amenity, and accordingly it will be taxable as perquisite in the hands of the employee. In the screen defined under section 17.2, which is subsection 2 of section 17, it's a benefit provided by the employer to the employee. It can be in cash form or is in kind. It's not in monetary terms such as accommodation, car, club, medical bills paid directly or reimbursed by the employer to the employee. Valuation of such benefit is prescribed under Rule 3 of the Income Tax Rules. Reimbursement of expenses which is related to the official duty. Reimbursement of expenses incurred for the official duty by the employee won't be taxable as perquisite. There are three types of perquisite. Either it is fully taxable, either it is fully exempt, or it is partly. First category is taxability of the perquisite in the hands of all the employees. In that, on the screen you can see, first category is Clause 1 of subsection 2 of section 70, where rent-free accommodation is provided by the employer to the employee. Exception being accommodation provided to judge of High Court and Supreme Court and officer of Parliament. It is exempt in the hands. Except for this category of person, it is taxable in hands of all the employees as rent-free accommodation provided by the employer to the employee. Second is, if there is concession in rent, if part of the rent is being paid by the employer, then if there is concession in the rent, and accordingly it's a benefit and taxable in the hands of the employee. Clause 4, where the obligation of the employee is paid by the employer. Example, domestic servant is engaged by an employee and the employer reimburses the salary paid to the servant. Clause 5, amount payable by employer directly or indirectly to affect an assurance on the life of the SSE, contract of annuity, other than RPF, approved superannuation fund or deposit linked insurance fund established under Coal Mines Provident Fund or Employees Provident Fund and Miscellaneous Provisions Act. So any amount which is paid by the employer to affect an assurance on the life of the SSE or for the contract of annuity will be taxable as perquisite in the hands of the employee. Exception, however, there are schemes like group annuity scheme, employee state insurance scheme, fidelity insurance scheme, under which insurance premium is paid by employer on behalf of the employees. Such payments are not regarded as perquisite because there is no immediate benefit accruing to the employee, because the benefit is dependent upon the contingent nature of the payment. Accordingly, it won't be taxable as perquisite where the payment is made by the employer under a group annuity scheme, employee state insurance scheme, and fidelity insurance scheme. Clause 5 should be clause 6. The value of any specified security or sweat equity shares allotted or transferred directly or indirectly by the employer or the former employer, free of cost or at concession rate to the SSE. So the value of the specified security or sweat equity shares, the valuation is derived, and accordingly the any benefit provided by the employer, any benefit which is provided by the employer will be subject to tax. This sub clauses, this all the clause will be discussing in detail. We are discussing this on it to provide a brief what subsection 2 of section 17 covers, what are the benefits and what should be the exact value of the benefit. We will be discussing this in rule 3 and in the subsequent topics. 7. Contribution to approved superannuation fund by the employer in excess of 1.5 lakhs. Any other fringe benefit or amenity as prescribed under rule 3.7. So sub rule 7 of rule 3 defines these following criteria, which will be termed as any other amenity and accordingly considered as taxable in the hands of the employee. First is interest free or concessional loan provided by the employer to the employee, traveling, touring and accommodation provided by the employer to the employee, free or concessional food and non-alcoholic beverages, gift, voucher or token in lieu of such gift, credit card expense, club expenditure which is paid by the employer on behalf of the employee, use of movable assets, transfer of movable assets and any other benefit or amenity. These points are covered under sub rule 7 of rule 3. Now the second category is perquisite, which is exempt for all. So first category that we have read is perquisites, which is taxable in the hands of all the employees except for few categories which are specifically mentioned. Second category is perquisites which are exempt for all the employees. First is telephone. Telephone provided by an employer to the employee at his residence, so it is exempt. Transport facility provided by the employer engaged in the business of carrying of passengers or goods. So transport facility which is provided by the employer in the business of carrying of passengers or goods to his employees, either free of charge or at concessional rate, will be exempt in the hands of the employee. Privilege passes and privilege ticket. Privilege passes and privilege ticket orders granted by Indian Railways to his employees will be exempt. Perquisites allowed outside India by the government. So perquisites which are allowed outside India by the government to an Indian citizen for rendering services outside India will be exempt. Employer's contribution to staff group insurance scheme is again exempt. Annual premium by employer on personal accident policy. Payment of annual premium by employer on personal accident policy affected by him on the life of the employee is exempt. Refreshment provided to all employees during working hours in office premises is exempt. Subsidized lunch or dinner provided to an employee. Recreational facilities including club facilities extended to employees in general. Recreational facilities including club facilities which is provided to all the employees, that is not restricted to few select employees. If it is provided generally, it's in general nature, then it will be exempt. Amount spent on training of employees, amount spent by the employer on training of employees, or amount paid for refresher management course including expenses on boarding and lodging, this will be exempt. Sum payable by employer to recognized provident fund or an approved superannuation fund. Sum payable by an employer to RPF or approved superannuation fund or deposit link insurance fund established under coal mines provident fund or employees provident fund and miscellaneous provisions act, it is exempt. Leave travel concession subject to conditions specified under section 10. So amount is exempt subject to certain specific conditions being satisfied. Value of leave travel concession provided to a high court judge or supreme court judge and members of his family are completely exempt without any conditions. medical facility is subject to certain prescribed conditions, so we will be discussing this in detail. Medical facility will be discussed in detail at a later point of time. Leave travel concession will be discussed in detail at a later point of time. Also, taxability of superannuation amount will be discussed in detail at a later point of time. Rent-free official residence. Rent-free official residence provided to a judge of High Court or Supreme Court is exempt. Rent-free furnished residence, including maintenance, provided to an officer of parliament, union minister, and a leader of opposition in parliament is exempt. Conveyance facility provided to High Court judges under Section 22B of High Court Judge Conditions of Service Act 1954 and Supreme Court judges under Section 23A of Supreme Court Judges Conditions of Service Act 1958. So in this we have read what are the exemption amount which the perquisite received by such employees, by such category of employees, will be exempt in the hands of the employees. So this concludes the definition of perquisite, in which we have taken two categories till now, in which the perquisite amount is taxable entirely for few employees and the perquisite amount is exempt for few categories of employees. The last category, which is the taxability of perquisite in the hands of specified employees, we will be discussing that at a later point of time in detail. Thank you.